Okay, boys and girls, welcome back. In this video, we're going to discuss fast scraping or HTTP scraping. Okay, this doesn't use the browser. Okay, and it's a way to scrape data really fast. This is following on from the video where we discussed masking and how you can get rid of stuff from the browser when it's loading to speed up scraping and lower resources. But the next step, if you want to use next to no resources and get quick results, then you can just scrape with getting the data via HTTP GET requests. So I'm going to show you that briefly now. Before we get into it, guys, just check out the new course that's out. It takes you from Bass Newbie to Bass God. There's also an option to have support, so you can contact me and the team and get support whenever you need, not just for the stuff that's covered in the course, but anything that's Bass related or programming related. So yeah, and you also get access to the Bass Underground, where you can join the group chat and talk with other people that are using Bass and shoot ideas off of each other. Also check out the Bot Empire, where we have different templates and resources for you to download, free videos. And also, if you need a custom bot or template designed, then you can hit us up there and we can get to work for you. Okay, guys, with that being said, let's move on with the demo. The template is in the description, so you can download this, play about with it, and get a better idea of how to use this. But what I've done is, if my mouse will work, is here is a list of different Reddit users. Okay, let me just show you. This is one of them. Okay, and what we're going to do is we're going to scrape the usernames. You can expand on this. You can make this multi-thread. We're just going to scrape the username of the different Reddit users, but you can scrape their karma when their account was made, put this into a database. We can go for miles and miles with this. We're going to start using this. If you're following the series that I'm making about Reddit bots, then this will be really handy. Here's the source code of this page. Okay, so all I've done is right-clicked, view source, and this is what we want to get our hands on. In the title, we took this information, and we're going to make a regex. Okay, so if you haven't already done so, guys, then you need to watch the video I made. I'll put a link in the after the video or in the description on using regexes. So I'm going to be really quick with this, so you need to go and watch that video so this will make sense. Also download the template and that will help as well. So I took this information. You need something before the information you want to grab and something afterwards. So there's something before that's on every page is the U forward slash, then the information I want, and then the curly bracket. Why have I forgot the name of the symbol? That. Okay, so what do I want to grab? I'm using the regular expression constructor that comes with Bass. Again, watch the video on regular expressions and this will obviously be clear. Select the result that I want. I wanted the username. Next, something that's before. This is always before. So it's the exact text, one time. Something afterwards. There you go, the bracket, exact match, one time. And then the information that I want is the username, which is in the middle. I don't know how many characters it's going to be. It's going to be a symbols. Any symbol is always the safe option because that could be a digit, a letter, or some kind of symbol, explanation mark, star, etc. How many times, how many digits or numbers is there going to be? Well, there's always going to be one or more. So click that. Match as few times as possible. And Bob's your uncle. There's my regular expression. So we can test it by if I grab some of the source code data there, copy, and go to our regular expression builder, put it in. If I put that in, the result would be this, which is perfect. That's the username. So I've already done that for our script. Okay, have I got a script running? No, of course not. So wait there. The other thing that I made is two resources. One is a URL list, which is a list of Reddit URLs, which are Reddit usernames. There's three in the list. And just a second. Excuse me, guys, just for 1 second. And then just a second resource of where to save the usernames. So to save our results, this is covered in other videos as well. So I'm aware I'm going quite quick, guys. It's because I want you to download the template and get an idea of how to do this. And if you've watched the previous videos, this will be clear anyway. So the Reddit URLs, it just points to a list of URLs that I've got users on Reddit, where to save the usernames, where to save the results. So here is the list of Reddit URLs. It's just free. And then I've just directed the bot where to save the usernames that we scrape. Okay, let's get over to the script editor. I'll show you what I made. Again, guys, this template is in the description, so you can download this yourselves and have a look. Just wait 8,000 hours for this script editor to load. That's going slow today. Everything is slow. Okay. Let's get to it. So what I've done, instead of using the browser option, I've come over to where it says HTTP client and then just use a GET request. Okay, so let me show you what I made. So what do I want to use? So I've done the GET request, sorry. And then what do I want to get? So I want to use the Reddit URLs resource, and then I put the do not use function again. Let me put it in so it becomes clear. So I want to use the resource. And which resource do I want to use? The Reddit URL list. And then all I did is uncheck the reuse resource option so that it doesn't use the same URL twice when we put this out in the field. Or run the bot for real, I should say. And then what I've done afterwards, so I get the URL with the GET request, then I want the bot to put the content of the page, the source code, into a variable called save content. So how I did that was, I'm still in the HTTP client folder, and then I just used the content option, and then leave it on auto, and for the variable name, save content, which is fine. And then I used a regular expression, which is covered in other videos. But so in the toolbox, it comes down to regular expression, and just use first match. Okay, so I just want to find the first match of the regular expression. So let me open the actual thing that I did. So here where it says the regular expression to use, I just used the regular expression that we made here. I copied it over so we know that it works, pasted it in here. And what do I want to run that regular expression against? Well, I want to run it against the save content variable, which so we made a GET request. We downloaded the source code of the page. We're running this regular expression on that saved source code. And then we're saving the data from the regular expression or what it scrapes into a variable called scrape username. And then what I've done, I've logged out that data by coming to the tools, log. And all I've done for our log is I found the username and then the scrape username variable, which will be the username that's found from the request. And then I'm going to write that username to a file, which is from the resource where to save the usernames. And what am I going to save? Well, the variable scraped username, which holds our username that we scraped from the source code. And I've just ticked the box, add an ending symbol, and then append. So it saves one, goes to the new line in the text file and saves to the next URL that it... the next username that it finds. So just quickly again, guys, make a GET request to the first URL, Reddit URL, and then do the second and the first. Save the source code into a variable called save content. Then use the regular expression that we built to go through that source code and scrape the information based on that regular expression we built. Then log out to the Bass console what we found. I found the username and then the scraped data, and then write that scraped data that we save, which is the variable scraped username, into a text file. And that is it, guys. The template is in the description. So let's just save what we did and let's run this bad boy. So just pointing the bot to the URLs, the Reddit URLs. I just saved three random ones. And then where to save the URLs that we scraped with the regular expression there. Press OK. And then it's going to run. Look at the log. I found the username Benty103. I found the username Wag the Cat, my bad. And then the third one, Scalibus. So it found three usernames in about a second, guys. So it went to each one of the pages, got the source code, run the regex to scrape the username, and then it's logged out to the console and Reddit usernames. I've already run this before. So let's see. There you go. It's got it more than once, guys, because I was doing tests before I'd done this video to make sure that everything was all good. So the demo gods didn't fail me. But it scrapes the data into the username as we into the text file as we asked it to. And that's it, guys. That is how you scrape data really fast without using a lot of resources or using the browser. So this is on a slow internet connection, and you could scrape a couple of results in a second. You could obviously, this is on one thread. You could have this on a VPS with 100 threads running through a list of thousands and thousands of URLs, scraping as much data as you want. Okay, guys, I hope this video has been an eye-opener and helped you out. Please, in the comments, let me know what videos you'd like to see, what information you want to learn. And please like this video, subscribe so you get notified of new videos as I release them. Okay, guys, I'll catch you in the next video.